West Africa, a place often neglected in history education, yet full of history, and for our purposes, empires. The empires here traded slaves to the Americas, traded gold on the Silk Routes, and had very notable effects on the world. Really, most of Africa could have held empires, with the exception being the Sahara. But for today, we're going to discuss West Africa. Also, we're not going to cover every known kingdom, but these are the most important and greatest. So take notes. Or not. I can't force you. Ghana was the first empire in this region, so let's start with it. Ghana was founded by Berbers in the 3rd century, most likely after one event. Peoples to the south started mining gold. Thus, Ghana was an intermediary between them and Berbers with salt, which preserves food. In the last several decades of the Roman Empire, Ghana became very rich, especially by 800. Also in the 800s, the Berber rulers were expelled, putting the subjugated people in charge. But Almoravids, in 1075, shortly conquered Ghana. But by 11 years later, Ghana was free. Yet because trade, the thing that kept the place running, was interrupted, it experienced a century of decline, which ended in the division of the empire near 1190. Another Berber-founded state was the very historically important Almoravid Empire. They grabbed power after a Cordoban monarchy collapsed under a king who was not taught how to be king. They were founded in 1040 and began expansion in 1053. By 1069, they were the most powerful empire in the region. But this was just the beginning. They possessed Ghana just over a decade, and from 1090 to 1110, reunited the Taifa states under their rule. Nonetheless, they still lost their Iberian hold by 1146, but before then, the strict rules of the Saharan Muslims clashed with the religious tolerance of Iberia. So what, you ask? Well, the Almohads is what. Basically, Almoravids were tolerant, and Almohads weren't. Thus, Almohads replaced Almoravids by 1147. Ghana left a power vacuum after it fractured, and Mali filled that vacuum. Mali was formed by the Malinkas in the latter half of the 1230s. Though originally oppressed by one of Ghana's successor states, the Malinkas united a handful of kingdoms, then conquered what was Ghana by 1250. All of this by their first king. Also, while Ghana was only Muslim after Almoravid pressure, Mali was Islamic at its foundation. In the first half of the 1280s, a new king, or Mansa, spread the empire east and west, but later died on a pilgrimage by 1300. Then Mansa Musa was in power for 25 years, from 1312, and he made an extravagant pilgrimage and annexed new lands, both within at most 6 years of each other. But after his death, Mali suffered a drawn-out decline and found an opponent. The Songhai had a city-state ever since 700, until it was conquered by the Malians in the early 1280s. The Songhais, not cozy with this, rebelled in 1375, but only possessed the state near 1389. Although it was a vassal, it gained independence after 1429 and conquered Mema in 1465. By 1473, they took Timbuktu from nomads that attacked caravans going to Mali and Djenne. The Songhai wanted these cities because they were trade centers and would bring stability and strength to their holders. By the 16th century, they were undisputedly the dominant power in the region. Eskia the Great, the third king, was a devout Muslim who incited immigration to his country from the rest of the Islamic world. After him, a number of civil wars broke out and Songhai was caught by... The Saudi Empire, or dynasty, was yet another Berber-founded society. They took power in Morocco after Portuguese domination ruined it, and the Portuguese could do this because of peace after this. Anyway, they destroyed that government in 1554 and had an unstable relationship with the Ottomans, so unstable that they took their vassal state, Tlemcen. Ahmed al-Manzar was a great king. He played Europeans off one another and stood up to the Ottomans. Thus, he had the resources to expand south and rule over the Songhai from the 1580s until they left in the late 1620s because it was too far. But by then, Mali had been divided like Ghana, and Songhai never came back. And in addition, almost immediately after, Saudi Morocco was losing bits of itself to former subjects. And like the rest of these great empires, in 1658, they fell. Africa would truly suffer centuries later.